Hello, so the game actually had some updates and now it's a little better. The starting experience is better. So let's speak about the Revolutionary Heritage. As you can see, I have 49. This is basically one game plus a few achievements. Now, if you're playing on the harder difficulties or if you just want to know, have a bigger challenge, you have to invest into the weapons, armor, trinkets, and a lot of other stuff. But if you're just playing on the normal difficulty with hardcore to finish the game once for the achievements, well, the most important things are, let's put one point into medicine and weapons because it's cheap. And then materials are the most important thing and also stats. So, materials and stats. So let's actually put one more over here. And then stats over here. Looks like there are also badges, so I guess this is silver already. Or bronze, silver, gold. Probably it will be more. I don't know, we'll have to see. Now, we have 4 more points, and to be honest, you don't really have a lot of options here, so I really recommend you put them into the weapons. And let's say the armor, because it can take a long while until you find something better, so let's start. Now, I didn't unlock the starting jobs, but most of them I have them, so will not play as a slave. I think I want a surgeon, most of all. You know what? Actually, there are a lot of cool ones. I mean, the bounty hunter and the bandit, and especially the spy is so good. But we'll just play our normal medic until we unlock something more interesting. I would also like to play the heavy infantry ones, but no. Again, this is another game where I actually play it just to make a lot of stats and, you know, get a lot of revolutionary heritage again. Archery, well, I just want the intelligence one, so I'll be a hacker, because we don't really need the fitness. So we have 3 points right now, starting points. So 5 intelligence. That will be actually more than enough. So we'll play again on the hardcore, because I want the bonus. As you can see, you'll also get more heritage points if you play on the harder difficulties, but the enemies will be stronger and the events will be harder to complete. I think time will pass faster, that means the danger level will increase a lot faster. Okay, let's start. The thing I like most about the game is that it's so addicting, I don't know. They did everything so good that you'll almost feel like you're playing a kind of like Mountain Blade. This War of Mine combined with Mountain Blade. Combined with a roguelike game, I don't know, it's just a unique experience.
Hey.
As you can see, she has 7 intelligence because of the hacker and the other stuff. Well, he's pretty good himself. So he'll go for strength. 6 and 7. That's actually pretty big. That's your starting weapons. Well, they're not much better than usually, but they'll do the job. Let's see if we can put an SMG on this position. Yeah, we can. Starting armor, the starting armor is a starting armor trinkets. Max HP morale, but a damage plus 10%. Okay, so even though the bonuses are quite small in the beginning, 7 of each and that one, you'll quickly see that it's a big, big difference. Now, I only said in the beginning that it's hard to get started. Also, check out the movement speed. So we have to follow those tracks. They move so slowly compared to my other team, which moved at a much faster pace. Now, the whole idea is to get more resources a lot more early, so collecting the drinking water will not be a problem. Of course, the perfect one is very hard to get. So for now, let's just focus on succeeding all the tasks. So we have the deep and wide. Well, this one, it's deep and wide. So that actually will prevent enemy strength growing faster. So I think a lot of people neglected this part of the game, but you can actually spend about 2 extra days in this mission if you don't select the right stuff. And 2 extra days means, well, the danger level will increase a lot faster. So this is our first enemy, so let's capture him. In the beginning, it's 10 times easier to capture people to increase the revolutionary morale. So after you get to 100 revolutionary morale, you get about 1000 cash, 1000 supplies, and also 1000 experience for your whole team. Remember that at that point your team should be about 8 people. So you'll have a lot of maxed out or semi-maxed out soldiers. Now you can also take the weapons and sell them, but since we don't have a good price for selling stuff, we'll just recruit them. Yeah, we'll recruit him because I don't know if we'll get someone better. But I want a spy or a sniper. At least someone who can handle himself. So far I think the spy and the snipers were the DPS classes that I really liked on that position. Or you know, I might just get someone for the buffs. Revolutionaries, no. I need someone to resolve, but that will be a lot harder to make. So after they reach about 55 points into a certain stat, it's no longer possible to increase the stat normally. So that means you have to go and increase other stats. So again, about level 15 or 16, they'll hit that cap. It's a hard cap, it's a hard lock. You can't put any more points into that rate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Also, all the time you have to buy supplies because food will sometimes be harder to get. Okay, that was not so bad. The wind is picking up, so weather is also pretty important. As you can see, a lot of times your speed will be decreased by the weather and some other events. So again, time only passes when you are, you know, doing something in the mission, not when you're standing still. And it's time for my bag of medicine, my favorite things to find. Come on, a perfect weapon? No. Even though I'm playing the beginning of the game a lot of times, it's pretty easy to... Okay, this will be harder. North. I think it's always north. Sometime I think it changed. So a lot of times when I'm playing the game, the first 30 minutes is the same, but after that it's so much more different.
Hey. Hey.
Wait, your special ops, what were your skills? Is it me or does his armor look different? Something changed. Well, I guess he's a veteran now. Since we already fought a few times. Some other stuff changed during the gameplay and I don't remember everything, but the game had about 4 patches since the release. 4 or 5 patches that actually increased a lot of stuff. So right now, as you can see, we're starting with a team limit of 4. Yeah, let's install a dynamite trap and let's capture him. Yeah, that's a bit unfair, but hey, they are bandits after all. We can't allow them to be unfair with us all the time. Also, the animations look just amazing for this game. As you can see, the shells or the cartridges are dropping on the floor. 25% chance to capture. Oh, a perfect weapon. Okay, this is the stat I like. Yeah, let's just repair the truck. You don't want to talk to me. The truck is at 97. That's weird. I guess they really wanted this DPS tank. For sure, DPS tank. The Witch Doctor and the Priest are pretty good, but again, they are not going to support you. The only support you need is her, the medic.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like he starts with the same stuff. His stuff doesn't really upgrade. Or I'm not really seeing it right now. 11 intelligence. That's huge. So we'll do a couple of missions and then you can see what I mean by that. Also, I think I learned so much about the game right now that I'm probably ready to finish it on the hardest difficulty. But to be honest, I just want to have all the heritage right now so I don't have to do it all over again. And it's quite stressful. If you play on the normal difficulty, I think you can finish the game if you accumulate about almost 100 heritage points to invest. Otherwise, you'll just get stumped because you will not know what to do in certain areas. Well, I don't need you. I could use you, but I'm not sure if it's worth it because you'll also get injured. And injuries are no fun. Let me tell you that. Speed and crit. That's a lot of firepower.
Hey.
Now, since he has a bit of strength, that means damage and agility is quite good, and intelligence is nice. I'll just give him the pistol. It fires fast, but it doesn't have a lot of accuracy. Let's also give her a pistol, because pistols can be used on the third row as well. Now that armor, this armor is not even worth it to look at. So what can we do with those points? Well, basically not much. Until we build our command centers. I guess we'll take him as well, but again, she's basically useless without a good weapon for that side. 25 decrease in accuracy, so that means his accuracy is somewhere under 40. Well, I guess he has 5 resolve. Okay, we'll take Utas. Now, usually this spot is reserved for Harun, and here is for Chris. Now, this changes all the time, so if you're lucky enough to get your first mission over here, it will be much better, because you can just go over here, complete the mission and have a very high level, and then you can do the rest of the map like this. So this is 50% of the map. This is the first... let's call it like this. This is the first part of the map, the second, the third, and the final one. So the goal is, remember, you should clear this map, the first part of the map, kind of like day 40 or 50. So that means we'll need a lot of speed. Yeah, but I don't have any truck weapons yet. And in the beginning you don't even have areas with effects, much less buildings. So I think all the areas with the buildings are somewhere around here. So this is where the buildings will start. I mean the farms, the mines, the pharmacies, the plants, everything that will give you a daily bonus is kind of like on that line. Now let's see what we can capture. Remember, we're looking for a spy. A 3-star spy. I think she's also 3 stars right now. Let me check. No, she's only 2 stars. I guess I need to increase her stats a lot more. Okay. So she's like Chris and Harun. It's also very fun. I think I'll also stream the game when I have a little bit of time. A storm is coming. Well, yes. And right now we're hunting for spam. Is that a pair of scissors? What are you? What is your profession? A gangster. Gangsters are also pretty nice, but I don't know, they're more like a debuffer type. Also, he'll help us capture people faster. They barely do any damage in the beginning, and the superior, look at the perfect weapon, how important it is. What if we fail to save them? No, let's just deliver them to the revolutionaries right now.
Hey.
Well, I'll need you for agility, so might as well invest a few points until, like I said, get someone new. But it's not so important. At some point during the game when you have 100 revolution, it doesn't matter what classes you have, because everyone will be the same level almost. Wow, we're saving a lot of people today. Accept payment. I'll accept payment. The guns are usually not that good. As long as we're not failing the checks, I'm happy. A vending machine. Oh, it's damaged. Well, that means you have to disassemble it for metal and transistors.
Hey.
Wait, what is your problem? Because you are very injured, right? This is what I mean. You don't want to spend a lot of points on someone who's so injured. Well, you know what they say, if he dies, he dies. As it is in MMA, where the referees actually sometimes did such a poor job that they you know, want... Oh, I like this one. The animations are also pretty cool, and the way the characters look. So in MMA, that is a meme almost. And if a fight isn't stopped at the right time, they say, if he dies, he dies. Let them fight or something like that. It's harder to explain the joke, but yeah, if he dies, he dies. Ah, that was so close to being a perfect one. Ah, that's... I don't really need the extra morale boost. So right now the area wealth increased by one level, so that means it will be two. And this is one of the things they modified with the patches as well. Because before it didn't really show you the area based on the updates. A little more revolution morale, that's also important. And also notice that when you are at the max revolution, morale starts to jump a lot faster. For some reasons, a lot of events are triggered. Okay. Close, but not close enough. Yeah, no chance in getting that one. Oh wow, we actually got almost everything. And another damaged car. Donate oil. Yeah, let's be a good person and donate some oil. That's a lot of good medicine, thank you. I'm starting to like this event, search for supplies. A car was carrying stones, why? Was it a, I don't know, construction truck? Yeah. Can't win them all. I guess the materials are nice. And this is, I feel already like the progress is much faster, so at some point when you're playing the game, sometimes you just have to say, hey, I have to quit, start again. Ah, that's only to remind me to be careful. And the traveling doctor is exactly what we needed. As for buying medicine this early, well, I don't really recommend it, so only buy the basic stuff. Ah, let's buy everything, we have the money. Nice, that will also heal some of the injuries. Actually, that was a perfect one, so we did heal. Okay, let's go. We didn't get much money because we basically spent it on supplies, but right now, the main goal is to always do the missions, always be on the travel. Don't stop because of the injuries or something like that. So, yeah, gather supplies to always do missions. No, I think we didn't capture anyone, that's bad. 12 wood. We almost completed... Oh, come on, we almost built it on the first day. Well, I'm not sure how we should proceed, but I will go something like this. Yeah, everything is very interesting. As you can see, you move so slow in the first days. Unknown building. Unknown building? Well, now they have my attention, so I'll probably go something like this. Yeah, we'll go something like that, because unknown building is something new. So as you can see, even if you play the game for, I don't know, 50 hours, you'll still find new stuff or new events. It's also pretty fun to play the game normally. It's very relaxing when you're not playing for, I don't know, 1 hour when you have to think about it. Doing a single mission is also pretty fun. She's a guard, probably. So that means she's not really valuable to us, but hey, revolution morale needs a boost. Okay, more intelligence. At this point, we're kind of nearing the cap. For the first part of the map, or the missions, bounty hunter. Well, I like the bounty hunter, to be honest. But again, he's more like a debuffer, not a direct damage type or a direct support type. I like that they have holsters and stuff on them. They really show that they are professional bandits or bounty hunters. Ooh, that hurt a lot.
Hey.
Also, I tend to forget this, but you have to set him as the captain, so he, as the captain of the team, so he resists injuries a lot better. Yeah, let's investigate this. Nice. Also, also have the vigor buff. The vigor buff can also be obtained by waiting normally.
Hey.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now, perfect. He is very resistant to injury, so the first part of the game should be a lot easier right now. Oh, this is such a big payday in the beginning. Oh, come on, that was so close to a perfect one.
Hey.
But it's so important that you kind of pass all your checks in the beginning. This is what happens when you pass the checks. You get experience and you level much faster. I think we'll reach level 6 with one more mission. Hello, revolutionary teams. Yeah, sure, let's help them. And also, let's capture another recruit for them. I think he's the Royal Guard. I don't really like them. Again, it's more to do with my playstyle. Sometimes they are better, but you know, if you're recording or playing for YouTube or Twitch, you just have to do it a lot faster. So that means my new companion or my new member has to be a DPS guy. Poor girl. Such a beautiful plane. As you can see, it's kind of like the scenic route over here. Now, you can do a lot of stuff, but if you disable the alarm, I'm not sure what happens. I should just tear it down for the stone. Oh yeah, I should remember that next time. I think this was fixed because before we didn't have an alarm. Help them build the future. That decreases the speed. I don't want stuff that decreases the speed. That could be good. What about the weapons? Oh, they are so expensive. EM howitzer. So basically the same weapon but a different tier. Yeah, let's help them build the future. So he'll only give me wrenches, okay. I guess you can use all the wrenches in one skill check. Okay, just let me give me a good skill check. Supply station. Sell supplies or buy supplies. Well, you know me, always buying the supplies. 69, that was good. I should have used the key, but I was not paying attention. Well, hello. Do you want to join the revolutionary armies? They have good benefits for you. He's probably saying no, but his body language will say yes in a few moments when he's lying on the floor. I like the little heart symbol behind him. A KSG? Well, that's actually pretty early to get such a good weapon, even though it's bad quality. Some people also ask me, how do you unlock the kitchen? I think it's a bit randomized, so I'm not sure if you can unlock certain stuff faster because it's all RNG, but do your best to keep your eyes open because sometimes you can unlock stuff just by keeping your eyes open. Okay. The game seems to love heavy troopers this time. I mean, we have one and there are another two. He's salting up quite good, but these guys are, you know... We forgot to disable the alarm. I mean, we didn't try to disable it, so this is what happens. They are higher level than me. Probably if we didn't have him, this would have been a lot harder. Yeah, let's switch to capture mode right now. Fortify supplies, yeah, a good level up. I should definitely start streaming the game, but I'm so busy with the other stuff. No, no more bombs for us, we're not a bomb squad. It has minus experience. Well, too bad, it was a good gun. I almost wanted to use it.
Hey.
nice. I mean, we lose some dodge, but the defense is so big in the beginning. Trust me, you want a lot of defense. Can actually go minus.
Hey. Hey.
Yes, you can actually go to the minus. That's hilarious. Trinkets are the same, nothing really changed, and we have enough wood to build this. Now, we could use the dispatch option.
Hey.
But I think I prefer an engineer.
Hey.
Hey.
We'll have to play with the engineer a little bit more. Five people, well.
Hey.
You are going over there. His strength is free. I guess it's also important to do all the missions pretty early.
Hey.
So the engineer is more like a defensive character. Defense, defense, and more defense. So I think I have a pistol for you or something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that will be enough. Nothing more, nothing less. 6 to 8. So we'll be using the pistol for a while. This is the pistol squad. We're actually a bounty hunter squad. Also have the infirmary unlock, so... These things are so important in the beginning, the herbal powder. I am using so much of them. And I should have saved some for the other stuff, but don't worry, we'll get more. Now I'm curious what... I don't think we have a track weapon. What is over here? The unknown building. I mean, what could it be so early in the game? Although sometimes you get this one. I don't know what causes it, but if you're in the right area, you'll actually save some fuel. Yes, let's go over here. And after this, we'll probably end the video because it's a lot of work. So, I'll probably finish the game this time. I'm not sure. I guess the game, it's about 20 hours to finish a single game or more if you want to play the long game. Well, the long but short game. Look at the size of those pistols. They're like SMGs. It's a big risk, so yeah, let's go for the medical waste. Damage safe. Well, let's go. I guess it will be a weapon or a... armor, it was money. Okay, at least the trash didn't fell down on us. Unknown building. Oh, nice, one stone. Now, fitness is pretty important in the building or the building infiltration. Or the... usually... Okay, this is the horror portion of the game. Such a great sound design. Now, usually when you infiltrate a building or you enter a building, you need certain skills like intelligence or a trap. And resolve. Why do you need resolve for a trap? Well, this will hurt a lot. We triggered it, the clown trap. That's very spooky, to be honest. Were those potato chips? I love potato chips. Mushroom flavor. Okay, let's scout this out. I don't know, for whatever reason, but when you get a perfect, you seem to get a lot more experience. Yeah, we'll have to go for the heal effect. And more intelligence. A shotgun trap. Look at this one. It's quite the amazing one. On the line, almost. It's also kind of a test of your observation skills. I tried to play the game while watching a movie, and actually I almost died because I stepped on a lot of traps. I used a lot of supplies. I didn't get a lot of supplies. Also, I want to do this for the tasks or for the skill challenges. That is not such a bad warehouse. Oh, finally an elite squadron. So this is a 3-star character. We might take her. So let's try to capture her with all our might. So she's only one, but to be honest, because of her stats, she is like 3 people already. Or 3 of my people at least. She also has pretty hair. Look at those pistols. It's like a police academy exam over here. Oh, that trauma really piles up. It's very risky to try and capture the elite ones like this. Yeah, it's Cap. And we still get hit. Oh, we actually captured them. That's nice. Saving them also. Oh, okay, that's... That's the best outcome we could have had. Well, she's still injured, but we can work on that. Fitness, damage. Yeah.
Hey.
Did I actually give you up points? Hey. Yes, I did. Well, since you're strength-based, go for the strength. Sorry about that, but this will probably be the last time we use this guy. I think we'll have to play with the bandit or whatever her class was, because we didn't find anything better. Are you an arch-critic housewife? 10 sins of modern medicine. Horrified. Okay, next time we'll not read that book. You have to also learn the books, otherwise... See, this is what I mean. When I was playing, watching a movie, I choose all the wrong stuff. Spider. A little wood. Okay, now we have enough to continue.
Hey.
We're already hitting a lot of perfects. And to be honest, you can't really afford to miss any skill checks or any dialogue checks or, you know, choose the wrong thing like I did over there. We don't... I'm not sure. Okay, so if we make a sacrifice, remember, if you do 9 sacrifices, you'll actually receive some bonus stats. So we'll have to do it anyway right now. That's his main side quest, or his main quest, I don't know. We'll just have to sacrifice 9 times. The rewards are not that bad, but to be honest, it's not really worth it sometimes. See what I mean? This is free wood in the beginning. This is a loss, a big loss. It's only for the duration of the mission, so that's... Yeah. An alarm door. Well, to be honest, the alarm doors seem to give the enemies more strength or more dangerous level. So we really don't want the alarms. Okay. Nearly fell, that one. The riot police, I think I like... No, I don't like them again. Too much protection. Too much... 21 intelligence already. That's so big. Is that a... Oh, I thought he had a knife on his rig over here. I like the boots. They're almost like clone trooper boots. Pew pew. Yeah, repair his armor. Oh, we actually got them. Okay, save them. Right, police. Well, you are a smoker. I don't want any people who smoke in my revolution. So we'll go to the front line. From whom? Okay. That spoke Zarathustra. Okay, let's be cultivated about this. Wow, that actually worked.
Hey.
This was written by Nietzsche, in case you don't know what that is. A lot of the things you see in the game are actually from real life, but they are a little modified. Actually, pretty cultivated game. Normally, a game doesn't have a high level of IQ, but I guess this is a lot above the average IQ for a game. That was almost a perfect. That was a perfect. Still a bit upset that we lost a bit of wood for that sacrifice. Okay, like I said, I think we reached the cap for the... You are a spy. Sadly, you don't have 3 stars and you have a lot of resolve instead of agility. But I guess we'll have to make you work as a double skill monkey. This is why I like them. Invincible for a bit. 1 enemy injuries and also minus HP per second. 6 damage and also more injuries. So it's all about the damage. And also dodge the entire battle. So they're pretty hard to hit and you don't have to waste a lot of money with them. So I hope I'll capture this spy. Nice. Now, I think because this is not an aggressive thing, you can also use it when you are capturing. Oh, never mind. I was not actually using the right thing on him. Oh well. That's how it goes sometimes. Let's hack his programming first. I think it will lower the prices. Yeah. Everything is 50% off, said the darkness. Yeah. I don't trust you, darkness. Okay, I think that's medicine. No, it's just a lot of resources. I'm surprised not... So basically they modified the game so only what's on the shelf is kind of like a secret. So you don't have to worry about missing stuff over here. But usually the TVs have something under them. Almost missed the chips. Vegetable soup. Well, to be honest, I'm always lacking in resolve. So we'll just have to buy the recipe. And I think we can always use it right now. Actually, we'll see when we get there. Speed. I would have liked to buy that. Patchwork armor. Carbon fiber armor. Yeah, I wish I had more money. As you can see, money is so important in the beginning of the game. Well, it looks like I found some extra money to buy extra wood. Thank you for the extra wood. Some extra money in the cassette. That was a weird place to put some oil in, but I can't complain too much. As you can see, I already mid-maxed a little bit and a lot of food, but barely any money. Because we had to pass so many challenges. Oh, and this is a small village. Wow. Daily cash and daily supplies. So the villages give you cash and supplies at the lowest level as well. Now, this will really boost our revolution morale and all of... Yeah, okay, you can have some oil. But just give me more supplies. Also, you also have to pay attention to what you're getting, because sometimes you forget that you get something and you will kind of miss out on a lot of other stuff. For example, you have to upgrade the buildings as soon as you can, because some of them will offer you passive bonus or other good effects. See? Free metal for that, and I had a lot of oil, so that actually worked out in my favor. This map is a little bigger than the rest. And it just keeps on going. Well, it's good for me, because in the beginning you have the chance to get a lot of stuff. Okay, if he's begging, you can have it. That was revolution morale a little bit. I guess we should have sold it, but... I'm not sure about that event. I have to check the footage when I... or play the event again to see what how much money I get for that. A little cash over here, but look at the supplies. Well, sadly our spy didn't survive the transition, so now... Well, this is pretty bad. I mean, he has 6 agility, but she has 16 fitness.
Hey.
So we'll just have to send him. Yeah, to the military. This is not going to help me a lot, but to be honest, like I said, you just have to put some people in the team. Well, you can use the sniper rifle. I rarely use them, but as you can see, they are accurate, they do a lot of damage, and they pierce. Eh, good enough. Damage. Well, the steel armor is not that good, to be honest, in the beginning. 12% experience. Well, I guess I want to level you as soon as possible, because that thing will increase your loot. Now, what do I want to build? Probably the truck, because that will also increase our speed. So, like I said, speed is the key in the game. Infirmary is also pretty important. We can also build that one in the warehouse. Well, we need a little more wood. And that's done. Now we can actually go over there. This is so much fun. See you next time. Bye.